أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبه يستعين في جميع الأمور الحمد لله الذي جعلنا ممن أوتي كتابه بيمينه فانقلب إلى أهله مسرورا وصلى الله على محمد وآله ودعاتهم الذين حباهم الله مقاما خطيرا مؤمنين مؤمنات السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته May Allah Ta'ala make you happy. May He place you in the company of the martyrs and the worshippers in heaven. Along with the happiness in this world, may He give you happiness in the hereafter. Most people wish to be happy and remain to be happy. But how is that possible when the conditions of this world are so unpredictable? Ups and downs, diseases, pain, quarrels, so many different kind of worries. All this is very real. We face these challenges day and night. In this world and in these circumstances, how can a mu'min remain happy? How can he strive to be, always be happy? What is the path to happiness and the deep philosophy behind it? I will do this bayan with Allah Ta'ala's aid and the barakat of His wali, Imam al-Zaman's inspiration, Ta'i. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, Oh my people, this present life is but a passing enjoyment. The world to come is the abiding home. Ya qawme, innama hazil hayatu dunya mata'un wa innal akhirata hiya darul qarar. Similarly, Allah's awliya constantly remind you that this world is an abode of trial and hardship, of toil and fatigue. We endure it all the time. That is the truth. And that truth and fact is important to recognize. Only then can you understand how to deal with difficulties and how to remain happy despite these realities. Allah Ta'ala also says in the Quran, وَإِنَّ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ لَهَيَ الْحَيَوَانِ The abode of the hereafter is the only true life, the life forever, if only they knew. The hereafter is the eternal home. It is the place of eternal life. Most people wish to remain alive in this world for as long as possible. They are afraid of death. For most people, if they were asked what would make you happier, having more money or having more years to live, they would choose a longer life. Some people spend so much money for medical treatments that give them only a few more months to live. It is clear that happiness is linked with life. If you wish to have eternal happiness, then eternal bliss, eternal life will be yours in the year after, as the Quran has promised. A mu'min knows why he has come into this world. I have done this bayan many times. The purpose of life here is to achieve, to earn eternal life in the year after. And the path to it is by answering the true da'wat. It becomes clear then that those who answer the true da'wat will be happy forever. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, O Mumineen, answer the da'wat, the call of God and the Rasul, Messenger, when they call you towards that which will give you life. How is it that God says He calls you towards that which will give you life? Isn't the address to the living? The meaning is that the one who calls towards eternal life. Amirul Mumineen salawatullah alayhi has said, al-Muminu hash-shun bash-shun. A mu'min is always bright and cheerful. He is always happy because he knows that because he has answered the Dawat, he will attain eternal bliss and blessings. That is why he performs good deeds in this world, cultivates virtue, leads a life dedicated to Allah Ta'ala's worship in order to obtain abundant reward from him. As we see in this world also, people work hard in order to expand their livelihood, advance their career, to get promoted, to get a raise in their salary. And when they do achieve success, they are very happy. It brings them happiness. This is good. But remember that this world is transient. Its happiness is temporary. The intelligent person will always prioritize the happiness that is permanent. Short-term thinking is not a wise choice. Death is real. I will discuss the reason for it in the future, inshallah. This world and everything in it will perish. The hereafter is the home of permanence, where there are no worries at all. Paradise has been described through metaphors and parables. All good things will be given to a mumin in paradise. Whatever he wants, he desires, will be his. We'll have eternal blessings and eternal happiness. I have recounted earlier that if you remember Allah Ta'ala remembers you, as said in the Quran, فَاسْكُرُونِ أَسْكُرْكُمْ. Similarly, if you please Allah's Wali by answering the true Dawat, Allah will grant you paradise and eternal bliss. How does one please Allah Ta'ala? Maulana Taher Fakhruddin, whose auspicious birth anniversary, Milad Mubarak, is this Friday, 27 Zilqada, he says in a verse, in a poem, if you wish to please Allah on His throne, then please Allah's Wali on His earth. Allah, answer Allah's Dawat at the hands of His Wali, His representative. Obey Him, please Him, and you will obtain eternal happiness. I wrote in a verse addressing Sayyidina Muhammad Burhanuddin Ridwanullah Alayhi in Arabic. I will translate it here. That with your slightest smile, my will becomes stronger. With your slightest smile upon me, my will becomes stronger. And in difficulties, I remain firm because of your smile. When a mumin possesses this belief, then the griefs and suffering of this world do not overwhelm him. Because he knows that he will have eternal happiness in paradise. Yes, many things that happen in this world that cause hurt, sadness. But as we always say that, if hardship ever knocks on your door, remember Aqa Hussein's suffering in Karbala. Your suffering will become lighter and easier to bear. There is a deep philosophy in remembering Hussein and weeping for him. Shall discuss that too, inshallah. There is some time. There is great reward for the one who weeps for Hussein. I will mention just one point briefly here. When a mumin remembers the suffering of Imam Hussein and his family, his companions, Ahle Bayt Ashab, he will be able to bear with fortitude and courage whatever suffering has come to him in this world. For Hussein's Ashab, as you know well, on the eve of Ashura, perfumed themselves with musk and were cheerful. Someone asked, how is that you put on musk and smile when you see death in the blades of sword ahead of you? They answered, we are not afraid of death. We will sacrifice our lives for Hussein and enter paradise and forever be happy. Maulana Muhammad Burhanuddin Ridwanullah Alayh always said these lines in supplication. Many Mumineen have heard this. We pray to Allah in the same manner today. May Allah Ta'ala keep Mumineen always happy. May He not give them any grief other than the grief of Hussein. Someone did arrest to me that he is suffering from depression. I told him, Remember Hussein and mourn his suffering. That is the cure for depression. When a mu'min remembers Mawla Hussein and accepts Allah's will and decree, meaning he's happy with whatever God has ordained for him, Rida bil Qadr, his life will be one of tranquility and peace. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, Ya ayyatuhan nafsul mutmainna. Addressing the soul, O soul, at peace return to your Lord. Radiyatan mardiyya, well pleased, well pleasing. Imam alayhi salam writes in the Ikhwan al-Safa that the true meaning of happiness is pure goodness, al-khayrul mahd. And the pure goodness, the best of all things, is faith, iman, being a mu'min. Being a mu'min is the greatest and truest sources of happiness. Because of his faith, mu'min is going to obtain eternal happiness. Isa Nabi and Yahya Nabi once came together, met each other. Isa Nabi, when they met, Isa Nabi smiled and cheerfully greeted Yahya Nabi. Yahya Nabi's face was downcast and he said to Isa that, oh, Isa, Spirit of God, Ruhullah, you laugh freely, you smile as though you were secure from Allah's punishment. Isa Nabi answered to Yahya, you show sadness as though you had no hope of Allah's mercy. At that time, Allah Ta'ala sent to both the prophets a revelation in which he said, أَحَبُّكُمَا إِلَيَّ أَبَشُّكُمَا بِصَاحِبِهِ. The one I love more is the one who is more cheerful. Our Mawali Tahirin have given us many counsels on this subject. They have said, Al-Bishro bi jami'in nas, greet everyone with a smile. Amil Mumineen, Salawatullahi alayhi said, cheerfulness captures affection. Whoever has the good fortune to be a mu'min is always happy, as you heard just now. And the marks of that happiness should be evident on his face, in his demeanor. His happiness affects others also very positively. Maulana Taher Saifuddin, in a verse in his poem, has said, greet everyone with a happy face and they will appreciate and respect you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that if you bring happiness to a mu'min's heart, Allah Ta'ala will wash away your sins. Baqir Imam salawatullahi alayhi has said that in the eyes of God, this bringing happiness to a mu'min is one of the best deeds you can ever perform. Mumineen, live a life of happiness in this world too. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, Allah's awliya have no fear. They do not grieve. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, five things are important contributors to happiness in this world. Meaning in this world, a good spouse, the first. The second, good children. Third, good friends. And fourth, obtaining livelihood in one's own place of residence. And the fifth, and the most important one, which gives eternal happiness, is the love for Muhammad's descendants. وَالْحُبُّ لِعَالِ مُحَمَّدٍ. Imam alayhi salam says in the Ikhwan al-Safa, the greatest happiness, felicity you can have is to find a teacher, Mufid, who knows the real truth of things and to learn from him and obtain the blessings of true knowledge. Haqnu ilm. Amin Mumineen salawatullah alayhi says, knowledge brings perfect happiness, whereas the happiness earned by deeds without knowledge is incomplete. Mumineen, remember the teachings of our Mawali and put them into practice. If you do, you will lead happy lives. And because of it, you will attain eternal bliss in heaven. Amir Mumineen has said, contentment is a treasure that never runs out. You attain contentment, happiness. How? By giving thanks to Allah Ta'ala for His blessings, always. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, وَإِن تَعُدُّ نَعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you try to enumerate Allah's blessings, you will never be able to count them. And Allah Ta'ala graciously promises that, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you give thanks, I shall increase your blessings. Keep that faith always in your heart. By the sanctity, hurmat of Muhammad, Ali Muhammad and their du'as, may Allah Ta'ala in His infinite mercy grant you happiness in this world and the hereafter. May He make each day for you as happy as the day of Eid. May He give you barakat in your children, your wealth, your trade, your livelihood, your belief, your knowledge, your deeds, and especially in your happiness. May He increase all these blessings for you many folds. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulihi Sayyidina Muhammadin wa alihi at-tahirin. Wasallama tasliman muttasilan ila yawmiddin.
Ya sabahal khamis ahlan wa sahalan.